No Film School's coverage of NAB is brought to you by Limelight, makers of professional lighting for independent filmmakers. My Road Reel International Film Contest. Enter at myroadreel.com.
Hey, it's Joe. I'm here with Robert from JuiceLink, and we're looking at the new Micro. This is the Little Darling.
It's the Little Darling, right. Exactly. So the Little Darling is a miniature audio recorder. Now, there's a lot of audio recorders that are on the market, but you know, I designed this with features that filmmakers will really appreciate. So, like, you know, I wanted something that was, you know, a belt pack kind of thing, a slip in pocket kind of thing that event people would typically use. So I didn't want to have like a big honking microphone off the top. So Lop that off. Also, you know, since it's going to be going into people's pockets, I didn't want to have any of the connectors coming out the side. All the connectors come out the top, and the connectors are locking, so somebody can't accidentally rip out the microphone in the middle of a recording.
Right.
It's also, you know, aluminum construction. And another feature is that when you want to stop the recording, you need to go in, you know, take your little pen, go into a recessed hole to stop the recording. So, like, when you slip into somebody's pocket and they're dancing around at the wedding and they sit down, they can't stop the recording or change the filter settings and stuff like that.
Right.
And you know, since it's a you're really only going to be using one microphone with it, a lavalier, but it's still a stereo recorder. So another valuable feature is we do audio bracketing. So we take, you know, basically the one microphone, we copy it over to the other track, we attenuate it by 16 dB. So as you're going along, if you blow out the main channel, you've got a backup channel in post. So you know, there's tons of applications for this, like, you know, eventers, obviously, like, you know, wedding people, like, instead of just, you know, miking up the groom and the pastor or something like that, mic up the entire wedding party, and then you've got everybody on an ISO track and post, and, like, you know, when grandma says something funny during the toast, you've actually got it, and you've captured that magical moment.
Right.
Or for, like, you know, guerrilla-type filmmaking, like, you know, you take the cameras are so good, and they're so small today, take the Blackmagic pocket camera, mic up four of your buddies and, you know, go into a bar without like a big sound crew and actually, you know, do some you know, guerrilla videotaping it on location.
Right.
Or you know, sort of like GoPro type of videos and stuff,
right,
like
small
that.
Cameras.
Small
right.
cameras. You know, well, GoPro in the sense of you know, like action stuff.
Right.
You know. So lots of applications.
So
really.
So this is where you're changing all your settings here. On this display.
Right, so this is the display, and for the user interface, you know, the main buttons are right out here, and you'll go into different menu settings, and for instance, when you're in the gain setting, when you're getting somebody hooked up, you'll go into the gain setting, and when you're in the gain setting, the second display is the meter. So, you know, you make sure their lav is set correctly, you plug in your headphones, and you're, you know, listening to make sure that there's not too much shirt noise and stuff like that, and you change the gain and, you know, make sure that the meter's happy. But then, you know, you're going to be disconnecting your microphone, or excuse me, your headphone, slipping it into somebody's pocket, but you still have the assurance and confidence that you're not going to, you know, blow out your recording because you've got the audio bracketing, so the backup post. So it's an aluminum case. You get to the battery by unscrewing this, and it takes a single AA battery. It'll last about 7 to 8 hours, and this is where you access the micro SD card. Pop that out, close that in, close it up, and button it up. And, you know, the battery compartment also is not something that can just sort of slip open. It locks with this nut. So.
And one thing you had mentioned is that you're using micro SD because of the size of the whole device. That regular SD was too big.
So, you know, a micro SD comes in about this deep, a regular SD takes up that much room, and I just don't, that's taking up room of circuitry that I need, so I can't fit a full SD card in it.
Right. So now, could someone accidentally turn up their gain in the, with the buttons here?
When you're in the recording setting, the only way to change anything is to take a pen and go through a hole that's, I don't have the hole punched in here, but it's going to be right here. When you're in record, the only way to change anything is to take a pen, go through the hole, and hit the recessed button that's beneath the hole. So that will stop the recording, and then you can change gain or whatever you want.
Yeah, that's great. And so I know you weren't quite set on price yet, but what's kind of the range that you're looking at right now?
So it'll probably come in somewhere around a Sony PCMM10, so, you know, like $200 to $240, something like that. It's going to be releasing over the summer.
Okay, great.
And subscribe to the JuiceLink blog, and then you'll be notified on the release and stuff like that. So
great, thank you very much.
Awesome.